Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Mohal Banker and today in this talk I'm going to discuss about how I find genicular artery which is responsible for cytokine release. The genicular artery embolization is a very advanced technique which reduces the knee pain by reducing the inflammatory action which is going on within the knee joint. So for that, to find out the culprit genicular artery is very important, and today in this talk I am going to show you how I find that culprit genicular artery. So there are particularly six genicular artery which is supplying the knee joint. If we divide this knee joint into two parts, the medial and lateral, then each side there are three responsible genicular artery, and you can see over here in this picture the three names of the artery is given over here, which is supplying on the medial side of the knee joint, and the rest of the three are on the lateral side of the knee joint. And when we do the angiography of the knee joint, there are lots of muscular branches also, but all these muscular branches are not supplying the knee joint, so we don't touch it, we don't try to cannulate these small muscular branches, but we target it, particularly this six genicular artery, and we try to find out artery which is responsible for cytokines release, these cytokines are responsible for inflammatory reaction within the joint. So now in this case, first patient has a pain over this region, so we have put this marker over here. And after putting the marker over here, we are just doing the cone beam CT. This is available in advanced cath lab. So when we are doing the angiography, we selectively cannulate this genicular artery, and then particularly then we do this cone beam CT scan to find out that is there any blood supply going from this genicular artery to this pain site or not. So I'm going to demonstrate you all these things into the detail. So these are descending genicular artery, the first artery which is supplying to the medial side of the knee joint. You can see over here these markers situated over here, and this descending genicular artery is gives there's a its branches of this descending genicular artery passes through these pain producing sites, but there is no vascular blood, so there is no hypervascularity over here. So this artery is not participating into the inflammatory reaction at the pain producing sites. So again, doing the angiography of different vessels, I found this muscular branch. And by just curiosity, I've done this angiography of this branch, whether this branch is participating into this inflammatory reaction or not. Just that information I want to rule out. But you can see over here, there is a contrast is going on within this within this muscular branch. One small branch is supplying to this pain-producing site, but there is no hypervascularity. So there is no hypervascular blood. So this muscular branch is not participating into the cytokine release. So the second genicular artery which I have seen, that is the inframedial genicular artery, and inframedial genicular artery is typically J-shaped artery, and it supplies the lower part of this knee joint medially, but it's blood supply from this inframedial genicular artery doesn't reach to this pain producing site over here. So these inframedial genicular artery is not a culprit artery which producing the cytokines at the site of pain. So now let's talk about this third genicular artery. It is called supramedial genicular artery, and with this microcatheter cannulated inside this supramedial genicular artery, and the contrast is injected. You can see over here, there is a blackish area over here. That is called vascular blush or the neovascularization, and this hypervascularity is suggestive of inflammatory action going on at this site, and the cytokines release over this area. This is a classically seen on this selective angiography. And if you remember our pain marker, so pain marker is situated over here, right? You can see over here. In this live angiography image also, you can see the pain marker is over here, and these inflammatory sites is also at the site at the near this pain marker. So typically this finding confirms that supramedial genicular artery is a culprit for cytokine release, and once I identify the culprit genicular artery, I plan for embolization. So there is a embolization material injected into the supramedial genicular artery, and these embolizing particle block these microvessels which releases these cytokines, and that's why the inflammatory reaction stops at the local site, and that is the reason patient pain is relieved. So now post embolization, this is how looks supramedial genicular artery. You can see over here that this is the supramedial genicular artery, but this hypervascularity which seen pre embolization images, it is not seen over here. So that hypervascularity disappeared after the embolization. And this is image of pre-embolization, these are hypervascularity, and these are pain marker over here, and the post-embolization, the pain marker is at the same site, but there is no hypervascularity seen over here. The rest of the genicular artery, these are descending genicular artery also filled up, but the hypervascularity or vascular blood disappeared after the embolization. So results, patient's knee pain 80% reduces, and genicular artery embolization is very advanced procedure, so done without any cut, without any suture, and because it is done with single needle puncture, patient is able to walk within 2 to 3 hours, and there is no physiotherapy required after this procedure. Patient's pain reduces significantly, and that's why many patients tell me that these are magical procedure, or there is a miracle that with this single needle puncture, patient's pain is reduces and a patient's quality life improves drastically. So thank you so much for listening to this talk, and with this talk you are able to understand that how I find this genicular artery which is responsible for inflammatory reaction going on within the knee joint. Thank you so much.